Hello there, everyone. I've got my week 11 DraftKings lineup coming right up for you for this week's Premier League contests. And starting off in goal, I've got Thibaut Courtois of Chelsea. $5,300 this week. Chelsea have been so good at the back recently. They've rediscovered that defensive form that I think everyone expected of them at the start of the season when Antonio Conte took over. It's taken a while for him to convert to this three defenders system that I bang on about every week, but it's benefiting Courtois as well. He's had 14.25 fantasy points over the last four games, which have all been win, clean sheet combos for Courtois. And I think he's going to be more busy than usual this week because Lukaku's up front for Everton, who loves to shoot. I think get Courtois in your lineup, you won't be disappointed. So moving into defence, you'll detect a bit of a theme here because I've gone for Marcos Alonso of Chelsea as well. So he's only $4,600 this week. I think he's incredible. He may be the best value player that I've got in this entire lineup, in fact. 8.8 fantasy points per game for Chelsea so far. He's at part of a big three-player stat that I've taken for Chelsea this week, but I think Alonso's taken to Chelsea like a duck to water. In his four starts for Chelsea, fantasy points record reads 17 points, 9 points, 10 points, 11 points. So alongside him, also from Chelsea, to fit in the big money starts up top, I've gone for David Luiz, 3,500. 5.6 fantasy points per game, so he isn't scoring that highly, but I believe that he is going to score a goal at some point. Maybe it won't be this weekend, but I think you're going to have to bite a bullet and take a central defender if you want to have a good lineup this weekend because the prices have started to inch up slightly again. Luiz always takes shots, and I think he's good for at least 8 or 9 points this week. So moving into midfield, bit of a homer pick here, but I've gone for Wilfred Zaha of Crystal Palace. $7,000, still very cheap. 11.1 fantasy points per game this season. Palace is player of the season so far, so you know what you're getting. And they're playing against Burnley, who were promoted last season. Good at home, but I think you can get at them down the flanks. He's also bettered his assist total from the Premier League last season, where he had, right, of his best Premier League season, sorry. He's got three so far this campaign. That's the best he's ever had. Shows you how maybe disappointing he was in the last campaigns, but this campaign he's doing really well so far. Palace don't keep clean sheets, so this guy is going to have to do something. Plus, he's the best dribbler in Europe right now. 5 dribbles per game, so there's that to think about too. Plus, he draws a lot of fouls. So alongside him in midfield, the man of the moment, Ilkay Gundogan of Manchester City. He's still only 4,800. 4 goals, 2 assists in his last 2 games for City. And that's in the Premier League and Champions League combined, of course. He's probably the best box-to-box midfielder in the Premier League right now. I think he's so cheap that he's almost a must-pick in all formats. Although, however, his ownership will be very high this week, so do watch out for that. Into the forward line, I've stayed with Manchester City. Kevin De Bruyne is $8,900 this week. I think that's cheap for De Bruyne personally. 14.8 fantasy points per game this season. Scored an absolutely amazing goal in the week for City in the Champions League to get them back into that game against Barcelona. And even after a small drop-off of form, he has been brilliant again. He had that injury, of course, as well. He's got over that by the looks of things. Got an assist in only 22 minutes off the bench against West Brom last time out in the Premier League. And he leads the league in assists with 5, plus 3.2 shots per game. It's not to be shirked at. So alongside him up front, I've gone for yet another midfielder. Yep, Dimitri Payet. You knew he was going to find his way in here. West Ham United's talisman, $9,300. He's a point-scoring machine on DraftKings. He had 11 points last week against Everton, which is incredibly disappointing for him. But I think all other players, if they were looking at their DraftKings points, would probably be happy with that. Stoke are far more obliging that. Stoke at home is a far easier matchup than Everton away. And I think Payet's going to get back on form. So into the utility spot, the final man in this lineup is Wabi Kadri of Sunderland, $6,200. 6.6 fantasy points per game this season. It doesn't really tell the whole story, though, because Moyes has only just started actually playing him from the start. I think he's one of Sunderland's best players, personally. Him and Defoe are the only two that I'd even consider having if I was the manager of a Premier League club. 8 crosses and 9.5 points last week would do just fine, really. I mean, I'd like him to get more than that. Maybe if you get an assist, Wabi, and I'll be happy with that. So, guys, that is my 8-man lineup. I'll go back through it for you. So, in goals, Courtois, defenders, Alonso and Luiz, midfield, Zaha and Gundogan, up front, Kevin De Bruyne and Dimitri Payet, and then utility man, Wabi Kadri. So, get involved in some contests this Saturday on DraftKings. Hit me up on Twitter if you've got anything to say about my 8-man lineup. It's at Jamie Hinks DK. Thank you very much.